Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. Recently, the Stable Diffusion Web UI Automatic 11.11 underwent a major update to Torch 2, resulting in a significant increase in performance. However, using the command line kit pull in your webui.bat file to keep the Web UI Automatic 11.11 update will not automatically update Torch and other applications. Many updates are required for this. Let's begin the update process. First, go to the PyTorch homepage and select your preference. Copy the following command. Then, navigate to your Stable Diffusion Web UI folder and open the command prompt. The screen should resemble the command prompt interface. Paste the copied command into the command prompt and click Enter. This action will initiate the automatic installation process, which may take some time depending on your network speed and the computer hardware specifications. Once the installation is complete, the command prompt will display a similar message. Occasionally, the automatic update may not work for you. In such cases, visit the NVIDIA homepage and download the latest driver. Additionally, update Cooler to the latest version. If you are unsure about your graphic card specification, press Winter plus R in Windows, type DXDIAG, and press Enter. This action will display your computer system information, including the graphic card details. Download appropriate driver and install it on your computer. If you continue to experience problems, consider deleting the VENV folder entirely. This folder represents the virtual environment folder used by PyTorch. Although you can still run ST Web UI Automatic 11.11 without it, having this folder may help resolve conflicts that may occur. You can now run webui.bat in the same root folder. This action will recreate the folder similar to when you initially run webui-user.bat. The updated items will still be present. Copy them using Ctrl-C and paste them into the command prompt using Ctrl-V. If everything goes well, you will have a Web UI Automatic 11.11 interface similar to the Mine interface. It is worth noting that while XFormers 11.8 or the latest version 12.0 is available, I can only use version 11.7 for my Stable Diffusion Web UI Automatic 11.11. Unfortunately, I have not yet found a solution to this problem. If anyone have a solution, please leave a comment to help all of us. Additionally, it has been suggested that using SDP, a SIGMaker distributed data parallel, instead of XFormers can enhance performance. For testing purpose, I have added a new virtual environment in the webui.bat file, set venv-dir equals venv-sdp. This action will create a new folder in the webui root directory. Remove --xformers option and add --opt-sdp-attention. Now restart webui.bat. Furthermore, it has been mentioned that a new version of pipe is available. Follow the same process as mentioned earlier. Copy the command and run it. You will notice that no XFormers are loaded, but the optimization SDP is applied. Restart webui.bat again, and load the webui automatic 11.11 interface. You will see that XFormers are not loaded. Now let's explore the new feature in the recent update. Changing the SAM has become easier. Go to the Settings submenu, then User Interface. In the Gradient SAM column, you can directly select one of the available SAMs. Restart the interface to see the change. Some SAMs, such as Pakistan, have a fancy appearance with a beautiful handwriting font, but they can be challenged to read. Now, you can also backup and restore the configuration. Go to Extension, Backup, Restore submenu. From there, you can save or restore the extensions, WebUI, or both configurations. These files are stored in the WebUI Configure States folder. You can save as many of your favorite themes or other configurations as you would like. Changing the weight of the text is now easier. Select the text and press Ctrl Up arrow to increase the weight or Ctrl Down arrow to decrease it. You can change the increment value in Settings, User Interface located here. After applying the settings, reroll the UI to see the changes. When browsing certain Stable Diffusion homepage like Silvertie, you may come across some nice images that you want to try on your local computer. Copy the prompt from Silvertie and paste it into the prompt area. Then click the arrow and all the parameters will be automatically moved to their corresponding places. The WebUI Automatic 1111 can now recognize parameter keywords such as negative, steps, seed, and more. These features makes your work much smoother and more efficient. Another great homepage, such as stablediffusion.fr, allows you to copy the entire content and paste it into the WebUI Automatic 1111 prompt area. By clicking the arrow, all the parameters will be placed automatically in their corresponding position. It is a very useful function. We have successfully updated PyTorch to version 2.0 and CUDA to version 11.8. Now we can use XFormers or SDP to improve the speed. Let's find out which one is better for my old RTX 2070 graphic card. Here is the hardware I am using. Operating system, Windows 11 Pro 64-bit. RAM, 32GB. Graphic card, NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2070 with 8GB memory. The SD motor I will be using is the default SD 1.5 motor. The stable diffusion parameters are as follows. Prompt, a dog. No negative prompt is used. The size is 512x512, which is the standard motor training size. I'm using the DPM++2M Keras sampling method, which provides very fast speed and good image quality with 20 to 30 steps. Since SDP works similar to XFormers to improve performance, it is recommended not to use them at the same time, especially for high-end NVIDIA graphic cards. The WebUI user.bat file without XFormers or SDP looks like this. I simply add a column at the beginning of this sentence. It is mean this sentence is a comment, it will not run. The WebUI.bat file used for SDP looks like this. I deleted column, now the option --opt-sdp-attention will take effect. There are a lot of options can be used, but this one may be the one of the best. And the WebUI user.bat file used for XFormers looks like this. I use default virtual environment folder venv now and delete --opt-sdp-attention and add --xformers. Every time you should restart WebUI.bat and reroll the WebUI Automatic 1111 interface. Here are the results. The speed without XFormers or SDP is the slowest, as we expected. It took 17.41 seconds to finish for image generation. The optimizing using SDP took about 12.4 seconds. The optimization using XFormers is the best, taking only 10.63 seconds to complete the job. I ran the process two more times, and the speeds were 9.74 seconds and 9.77 seconds, respectively. It seems that SDP optimization does not work better than XFormers for my old RTX 2070 graphic card. In the PyTorch introduction, SDP optimization is claimed to yield the best results especially on new NVIDIA cards like the 4000 series. Now let's find out how performance improvement in the new version compare with the older version, Torch 1.13 and CUDA 11.7, with the XFormers 0.0.16. I have uploaded a video that discussed a maximum image size that SD WebUI Automatic 1111 can generate directly using the high resolution fix function, and the speed that generates this image. Using the same resolution and parameter, I will do the investigation using SDP and XFormers optimization method. Here are the results. For the older version, the speed of OLED and the DPM plus 2M cameras are almost the same. However, in the new version, they are very different. The DPM plus 2M cameras sampling for the SDP optimization method is almost the same as OLED A at the starting, and decreases the speed a little in the large scale region. For XFormers optimization, the DPM plus 2M cameras increase the performance a lot. Also, in the new version, the maximum size is significantly increased. They all extended to 2.8 times without crash. I did not test which is the maximum it can be extended, since I will use ControlNet to enlarge image, which can get the better image quality. Also, very interesting is that there is no car in the image when the large scale is applied. It shows a city transport map for me. In conclusion, the new version increased the stability a lot,
and also increased the speed by about 40% when using XFormers.
If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.